Since Austria has a lot to offer, this small European country is one of the most popular destinations not only for Germans and Swiss, but also for people from many other countries. Austria ranks second on the list of the Germans' favorite immigration destinations, behind Switzerland in first place and ahead of the USA at third place. Back in 2016, Austria recorded an international net migration gain of more than 67,600 people, whereas in 2015, this figure was at an eye-popping 113,000 due to the refugee crisis. So the question arises, why is Austria such a popular destination for international migrants, and also what are the main upsides of moving to Austria? That is why I would like to use the time we have to highlight what I believe are the 8 biggest upsides of moving to the European country of Austria. First comes quality of life. The Austrian capital city Vienna is known for occupying the highest places in quality of life comparisons. According to the World Economic Forum Quality of Life Index for Cities, Vienna ranks 5th among all cities worldwide. But not only the city of Vienna, but also Austria as a country is always rated highly in terms of quality of life. If we take a look at the Numbeo Quality of Life Index, Austria ranks 4th worldwide. However, it must also be mentioned that Switzerland is rated even higher in both comparisons. Furthermore, these comparisons should always be taken with a grain of salt, as there are many such comparisons out there. Nevertheless, this indicates that a life in Austria is great. The geographical location of Austria is another advantage. As a centrally located country in Europe, you have the possibility to explore many different nations and cultures, whether Italy, Slovenia and the Balkan Peninsula to the south, Hungary and Slovakia to the east, the Czech Republic and Germany to the north, or Switzerland and Liechtenstein to the west. You will hardly be able to avoid discovering these countries. From Vienna, it is just a 1-hour drive till Bratislava, the capital of Slovakia, 3 hours to Budapest, the capital of Hungary, 4 hours to Prague, the capital of the Czech Republic, Ljubljana, the capital of Slovenia, or Zagreb, the capital of Croatia. The next plus is the Austrian culture. When in Austria, expect people to arrive on time, so you should as well. Austrians love sweets such as cakes, but also coffee, so don't be surprised to see tons of pastry shops distributed around the whole city. All kinds of winter sports are extremely popular in Austria. This is not surprising, considering the fact that a big chunk of the Austrian country is covered by mountains. So you see, even though it shares a lot of similarities with the German culture, the Austrian one still has its own peculiarities. Nevertheless, depending on the region to which you want to move to, you will be able to expand your cultural backpack with the varieties of the Austrian culture. Yet another upside is the diverse nature of Austria. One should not forget that Austria is one of the 8 Alpine countries, which Italy, France, Switzerland, Germany, Slovenia, Liechtenstein, Monaco and Austria are part of. The Eastern Alps make up a whopping 62% of the entire country, which opens all doors for activities that are related to the Alps. The impressive Austrian Alpine regions invite you to go on hiking trips during summer and skiing holidays in winter. You even get a chance to visit glaciers, for instance the one located in the Ötztal. In the country's east, the Vienna Basin is situated at, which is a rather flat region. The Austrian climate is also an advantage. Of course, this is dependent on your personal preferences. In Austria, you'll be able to enjoy all 4 seasons, thanks to the continental climate. In Vienna, maximum temperatures are at 26 degrees Celsius or 79 degrees Fahrenheit in July, and minimum temperatures at -0.8 degrees Celsius or 31 degrees Fahrenheit in January. The next benefit is the slightly lower cost of living, at least compared to Germany. The cost of living in Vienna is around 3% lower than in Berlin, 11% lower than in Frankfurt, and around 19% lower than in Munich. It also is about 18% lower than in Denver, Colorado, 23% lower than in Miami, Florida, and 7% lower than in Dallas, Texas. However, the wages are also a bit lower compared to Germany or the US. Due to the fact that the city of Vienna seems to have a monopoly over apartments in Vienna and also is one of the largest landlords in Europe, rents are artificially kept low. This is why rental prices for apartments in Vienna are low, especially considering the high quality of life you get there. However, this also means that tenants who live in an apartment in the city of Vienna pass the apartment to friends when they move out. So these inexpensive apartments usually do not even appear on the market. In addition to many companies that have settled down in Austria and especially in the capital Vienna, there are also many international organizations located there. And these include not only organizations from the European Union, for instance the Agency of Fundamental Rights, the European Cartel Association, or the European Nationality Congress, but also branches of the UN, for instance the United Nations Commission for International Trade Law, or the United Nations Platform for Space Information, Disaster Management and Emergency Response. So it might be worth taking a look at the Austrian job market. Here are a few other interesting facts about Austria. Where does the Austrian flag come from? the red, white, red flag of Austria has a not so nice legend of origin. The red comes from the opponent's blood. In the 11th century, Duke Leopold V is said to have fought in white clothes that were soaked in blood at the end of a fight. Only where his belt had encircled the white fabric, there was a white stripe left. But unfortunately, the real origin of the Austrian flag is not known. The fact that name titles have quite a high importance in Austria is a widespread cliché, but it is not unjustified. Younger generations are placing less and less importance on seeing their names flanked by titles, but in this country people still care about them. A very telling anecdote about the importance of titles in Austria is the following. When high school teachers once asked Emperor Franz Joseph for a salary increase, he declined the request but allowed them to call themselves professor from now on. The gentlemen were satisfied with that. Amazing but true. Vienna is the smallest federal state in terms of area. It only makes up around 0.5% of the area of Austria, but is home to 21% of the total population. In 2020, 1.9 million people were living in the 23 districts of the federal capital. The oldest daily newspaper in the world that is still published regularly comes from Vienna and is none other than the Vienna newspaper, or Wiener Zeitung. It was founded in 1703, but not only contained regional and international news, but also news of birth, marriage and death from the nobility. It is 100% owned by the Republic of Austria. The first postcards worldwide were sent from the dual monarchy of Austria and Hungary. If you want to know more about the process of moving to Austria, please have a look at my video that targets this topic. You'll find the link down in the video description. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for free to not miss any new videos about the world's interesting cities and countries. Thanks for watching.